Hey everyone, welcome to my new video. Well, before we start, I'd like to simply say that I'm a newbie just meeting with Shopify world. And I'm assuming you are the same if you're simply in this video. So I've done some e-commerce in the past, but never had a Shopify store. If you already have your Shopify store set, you can simply skip this video, because in this video, what I'll be doing is simply checking the plans, I'll be comparing them, and I'm gonna be choosing the one that fits best for me. So if you can stick with me until the very end, that is exactly what I'll be trying to giving to you. What is great is that Shopify is simply offering 14 days free trial. So even if before choosing a plan, we can use the 14 free days trial that they're offering and see if our store is actually working or not. And I've added a direct link that you can simply click and get your 14 days free trial in the description. So when we first take a look, it looks like that they have 3 plans, but in fact, they have 5 plans. So when we scroll down, we see the other 2 plans that they have. One is $9 a month plan, and the other one is Shopify Plus. So this $9 a month one is simply allowing you to use the app, but then actually build a store. So if you're doing some sales through Facebook, Facebook Marketplace, chats, eBay, Etsy, those kind of platforms, you can use the Shopify app, but you can't build your own store through the Shopify. And if I talk about Shopify Plus, this one is for big businesses, like Simply. It's $2,000 a month. Obviously, not the one I'm going with, but like this has the best rate out of all and the lowest that they're taking. Anyways, so if I talk about the fees that they're taking, one of the most important thing is basic one is 2.9 plus 30 cents. And with Shopify one is 2.6 plus 30 cents for the each sale that you're gonna have. And with the advanced one, it's 2.4 plus 30 cents for the, this has the best rate, as you see. I will do some math and I will say, okay, when it's mathematically like making sense for you to change and move on, and it's coming in the video as well if you wait. The other important thing is simply the features that the differences they have. These features are not gonna matter much if I'm just a beginner, because there's something called app add-ons. It's pretty much the features that you can add to your store from the app store that they have on the Shopify. You can simply install it to your store and you can use it from there. If you're a beginner, when your numbers are and sales are low, most of those add-ons are free. And for the ones that they're not free, they're like $14, $15 a month. So even if you add that $14 with this $29, it still doesn't make that $79. So if you're a beginner, obviously like 29 basic one is the one that I think makes most sense to go on. So simply the other thing that I like to discuss here is when it is a good time for you to change the plan that you're using depends on the fees. So we can calculate this with the revenue that you have, and there's a math that somebody already did the calculation that I simply want to share with you. If you're making up to like $16,665 in revenue in a month, you can be using like $29 a month plan, basic Shopify. To move the 791, you have to be doing anything more than $16,665 to $110,000. You can use the Shopify one, you can use the $79 one for the fees, it makes sense. From $110,000 to $1,000,000, you can move on to the advanced one in order to make the best number for yourself from the fees that you're losing. And if you're doing more than $1,000,000, you can simply move on with this $2,000 Shopify Plus plan. And these are the revenues, the total sales you have in your store. All right, with that being said, that's it for the differences. Obviously, the one for the beginners is making much, like most sense as the basic one. So I think I'll be also moving on with this one. So we can simply take a look how the setting the payments are. After you hitting the link on my bio to start your 14 days free trial, this is the page that you will be getting. And actually before this page, you put your email, you choose your password, and then you write your store name. We just like testing it. I put like Voice of Ur, which is my store name for the channel name. And there's a question that says that, are you selling? I'm never choosing this. I'm just playing around. I'm saying like, no, I'm not selling your products yet. And then they ask, do we have something to sell? Again, there's this option that you can choose that you're just playing around with Shopify. I'm saying that no, I'm brainstorming on what to sell. I think choosing like these ones, like, is kind of more realistic. I don't know. I'm just like going with that. And my revenue, current revenue, since I'm starting, I don't have any. And you choose whatever niche you're in. Let's say we go with toys. After this, we put our address, we put our name. I'll be also like doing it. You can also put your own address and everything. If you simply put your address, this is the page that you should be coming to. This is simply our dashboard. So in order to set the payments, we go to settings. And in settings, there's an option called payments. After we click payments, we simply get here. If you are based in the US, there's simply no reason for you to not going with the Shopify payments, okay? One thing that I didn't mention when I was comparing the plans, it's super important. If you are adding like different payment provider, it is an extra 2% fee that they're charging, okay? It's like 2% flat. So let's say you're gonna put your Stripe, you're gonna do it with your Stripe. Let's say Stripe is charging like 4% fee, Shopify is gonna have also additional 2% fee. So you'll be losing 6% out of the total. And that is the main reason that, again, I'm saying, if ever like you're based in the US, simple like setup for the Shopify payments. One other part that I'd like to mention, if you scroll all the way down, there's this payment capture. Do not change this to manually. Make sure this one is automatically, because otherwise you'll be taking the whole each transaction and accepting it and everything. And also there's an option that you can reject some cards that they are allowing you to do so. I'm not doing it, but like, I don't know, if you're thinking like some certain countries or some certain type of cards are risky for your business, you can do that as well. So I'm not going to show that one. And we hit this complete account setup. And after we hit this complete account setup, we have this the form, like sort of like some information that we should be putting. So simply, if you're having an individual account, you can choose to like this one. Or if you have your company, if it's a single member LLC, please choose. But if you have a corporation or an LLC that you have a partnership in, a US company, you can choose. You know, I have like single member, that's why I'll be going with that one. So employer identification number is simply a tax ID of your company, and you can get it from IRS. Simply their directions on the website of the IRS. You put your address that you have and your personal details, date of birth and everything. Okay, product details. So simply, I want you to write something. It was about toys. I want you to write something here that is briefly telling about what you will be doing. Please, like, this is one of the, I think, least things that affects the acceptance rate that they have in Shopify. But please don't write something here funny that can lead you to get a rejection. So I can simply write something like, we are online retailer of toys brand, and our store name or our brand name. And if I tell about this customer billing statement, this is simply on the credit card statement, the way that it's going to be shown. Simply like, if you applied it with your company, definitely put your company name here. If you're an individual, you can like put your store name or something. For the phone number, I wouldn't recommend putting personal phone number. Instead, you can like have Google Voice or any virtual number, because you can use the same number. It's going to be on their statement. So you can use this same number for the customer support and everything in your store as well. And we put our like banking information for them to be able to deposit the income we have. And yes, for the payments, that was simply it. Like until here, if we kind of like, you know, follow the steps that I'm mentioning so shortly, mostly it's going to be accepted.
All right, everyone. So that was it for today. I did my best trying to explain to you the differences between the plans and the payment settings. If you are setting your Shopify store, you can simply use the link that I put on my description to start your 14 days free trial. And I do have a bonus for the ones who waited until the very end of this video. So simply, if you're having a hard time setting your Shopify payments, you may simply consider setting a US entity. Having a US LLC and banking is gonna make things way easier for you.